Rather than striking at the heart of the establishment, the audacious activities were mostly confined to school children. Racist comics were circulated in the playground.
I think that they are written in good, honest, straight, simple language for young people, and they convey very simple, basic ideas of patriotism in a way that's acceptable and appreciated by young people. And as propaganda, they're brilliant.
Only 10 pence a copy!
Bulldog was the National Front's youth magazine. It had been founded in 1977 by 16-year-old Joe Pierce. For Bulldog, the conspiracy against the National Front started in the classroom.
When I was at school, my particular school, which is not one of the most heavily immigrant-populated ones, and it's not in one of the worst areas of London, that was inundated with communist teachers, and most schools in the East End, which the paper was supposed to go to, is most definitely inundated with red teachers. It makes me sick.
Oh, lovely, yes, to have a big nose, right? Come on then, yes.
Bulldog encouraged pupils to denounce left-wing teachers.
Now, Adrian.
It has big ears.
It has big ears. Well, I wouldn't like to be called big ears.
Dear sir, I am writing to inform you of another teacher to put on your Bulldog blacklist.
He has been known to advocate socialism and multiracism to his pupils. He also expressed...
And I would love to get my own back on him by seeing his name printed in Bulldog.
The NF. I have taken the trouble to find out his address. It is...
He made his students paint a hammer and sickle during a history lesson, and he encourages discussion of Marxism in the classroom. His name is Stephen H. Harrowell.
In 1980, I was a new history teacher at a secondary school in Dover. I was teaching the history of the Soviet Union, as was part of the school syllabus, and one afternoon, two young thugs burst into the classroom. We had an altercation in front of a class full of 13-year-olds. I felt physically threatened. They certainly verbally threatened me. I was accused of indoctrinating the minds of young British people with foul communist ideas, basically.
Were you a communist?
No, I certainly was not. It just so happened that year group, year nine, we were doing a term on the Soviet Union, to be followed by a term on the United States of America, and a term on the history of Africa.
Following the attempt on his lesson, Harrowell and the school became the focus of further National Front activity. Other teachers in Britain had petrol poured through their letterboxes or were beaten up. But vandalism and intimidation failed to bring down the multiracial society. Joe Pierce, editor of Bulldog, was jailed for racial hatred